you guys want opening credits?
I'll give you some opening credits.
So I was looking through my YouTube channel the other day and I realized, guess what, guys? I reached 330 subscribers. And that's a big milestone for me, since this channel's been around for 10 years. With the future of this channel looking so bright, I'm gonna have to start wearing these shades.
God, those look fucking lame.
Just shut the fuck up and try to do a fucking review. Welcome back to another honorable mention on my top 10 worst Tales from the Crypt list. This one is... it's a doozy. I apologize for my southern slang, but this is an episode that takes place on the farm. And it's yet another episode that's directed by Tom Holland. I don't know why his episodes are so fucking shitty. The guy directed fucking Child's Play, Fright Night... Well, and he did Langoliers, too. I really don't want to get too deep into the plot with this, but let's just say that this is a scarecrow story in the most loosest way as possible. So who's in this episode? Well, the main star of this episode, of course, is Patricia Arquette. And I don't have to introduce her to you guys. She's been in everything from Medium to Prayer of the Fucking Roller Boys. I don't know how the Snaggletooth made her more successful than her sibling counterparts, but she's always managed to get more work. Also starring in this episode is Kelsey Ross. You probably remember him as Eddie Harris from the movie Major League, which is an awesome baseball movie. If you've never seen it, check it out. But I remember him the most as Colonel Oates from Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey. And last but not least, we got Susan Blumerit, who also played Missy Dendridge from Pet Sematary. And she also played Betty Wolf in that Johnny Cakes episode of The Sopranos. That makes me hungry for some reason. Believe it or not, it's the same guy who wrote the last shitty episode that I just reviewed. So, Stephen Dodd wrote this one also. Other than that, let's just watch this episode. Basically, we're going to be watching Silk Stockings meets the Waltons. This episode's pretty fucked up. It's called Four-Sided Triangle. God, that is fucking stupid.
So we're introduced to this episode with Susan Blumerit playing one of our main characters, Louisa. Louisa really likes coffee in the morning, and when coffee isn't made in the morning, she throws the pot on the floor. And she starts yelling like a total fucking mad bitch. And decides, hey, I've got this indentured servant chick that's been just sleeping on ass all day. Why isn't my coffee made? You suck as a barista. Get your ass out in the fucking kitchen and listen to me. You suck at fucking coffee, but that doesn't mean that you can't take your skanky ass out to get me some eggs for a bitch omelet. On our way to go grab some huevos, we're introduced to our other main character, Louisa's husband, George, played by Kelsey Ross. And he's just wishing that she would grab his huevos. George is like the king of hands-free e-jacking. He can totally bust a nut without even touching it. Plus, he's aroused by the smell of chicken shit. While Mary Jo is gathering eggs, you all know what's going on here. And George officially reaches climax. Jizz in my pants. Due to George's O-face moaning, Mary Jo's frolicking in the chicken coop is cut short. She realizes something's up. Somebody might be watching her. And her only escape is actually wrapped around the neck of this douchebag. Ignorant but observant, George realizes her plans and tells her to go milk the fucking cows instead. Of course, George just wants to watch her milk the cows and pretend the udders are his cock. And while he's sporting massive, fully torqued wood, his creepiness equals calamity and alerts Mary Jo.
What do you want?
And this first rape attempt is brought to you by our sponsors.
Got milk?
It's time to prevent sexual violence.
Since homogenized milk doesn't work the same as bear mace, she is still attacked by this milk-covered rapist. And I'd like to remind you that all those early commercials of Bill Cosby promoting Jell-O pudding were filled with this farm's natural skim milk. George is now covered in milk, technically making him a serial rapist. And that means George is persistent. He threatens to call the cops because he picked up Mary Jo from some liquor store robbery. She says go ahead, and he hits her in the head with a bottle. Louisa incidentally shows up to the rape party wondering where her bitch omelets are. But little does she know that it might be a necrophilia party. Surprisingly, Mary Jo has managed to actually leave on foot after being hit in the head with a giant milk fucking bottle and seeks refuge in the arms of a scarecrow that is clearly caused by hallucinations due to her concussion. And for some reason, Mary Jo believes that this is her new boyfriend.
I want him to make love to me. What do you want it?
So Mary Jo's busted face magically heals and she decides to make some sexy dinner. And this second rape attempt is brought to you by Dinty Moore Stew.
America's favorite beef stew. It's a real meat and potatoes meal.
So concussed teenagers that make beef stew really get George horny, and he just doesn't know how to take no for an answer. But Louisa eventually hears what's going on and smells what she's cooking and becomes hip to their shit. But Louisa's enlightenment doesn't stop George from trying to rape Mary Jo a third time, and I'm all out of sponsors, guys. George sneaks back into the house thinking that Louisa doesn't notice, but she does, and she is fucking pissed. This leads her to stay awake the next night to see where George is actually going. And when he's not there, she decides to take the tractor out to the cornfields and find out what the fuck's going on. And it turns out George has been dressing up like the Scarecrow, who looks like the drummer from Slipknot this whole time, in order to get free blowjobs. Of course, Louisa is oblivious to this concept, and she's never seen Revenge of the Nerds, so she doesn't know the whole costume switcheroo trick. She ends up stabbing her own husband with a pitchfork. Louisa realizes that she killed her husband. Mary Jo kills Louisa.
He's calling me, I gotta get up, gotta get out, gotta get away.
So that's the end of the fucking episode. I didn't want to wallow in it too long because I already took a shower today. And until next time when I do another one of these, Team Media Horror, go!